Hello, I am Manish. I will explain how to solve the continuous beam using Abacus software. So we have to solve this. So for this, I will be creating 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes in Abacus using the beam element. So firstly, we'll go for part. We can write it as a continuous beam, and I'm selecting Y as a 2D element. Can give approximate size as 10, 100, anything we can give. Continue. Now we have to create 3 elements. So select create lines. 1 element, 2 element, and 3 element. We have to give dimensions to those elements. So this element is 5 meter, and this is 2 meter, and this is also 2 meter. We have done with the part. Close it. Done. We have done with the part. Now we have to go with the property. So property, we have to create material. We can write our material steel. So write steel here. We know the density of steel is 7850. We have to give mechanical properties also. Elastic. Young's modulus. So in our problem, Young's modulus is 200 GPa. Sorry, 200 GPa. So 200 is 0.9 and Poisson's ratio is 0.3 only. Okay, now we have to create section with that property. We have to go for beam as element is wire. Continue. We have to create profile here. So I'm using a rectangular profile. Continue. And I am using this dimensions, width as a 0.25 and depth as a 0.2. Depth as a 0.2 and width as a 0.225. Okay. I have created the profile and material already came here, steel. Okay. Now we have to assign this section to this element. Select both element. You have to select both element. All three elements, I think. Done. Okay. Properties assigned. Now we have to go for assembly, create instances, independent. Okay. Now go for step, create a step. We'll go with the dynamic, explicit, analysis of a static problem. Okay. Now we'll be giving load. So firstly, we will go for boundary conditions. So we have to look into figure first. So this is fix. So fix this. Fix symmetry. Continue. Select this node. Done. And cast it. Okay. Fix is done. Now this support is roller and this is also roller. So we have to create one more boundary condition. We have to go for different displacement and rotation. Continue. Select this node. Select as this node also. Continue. Roller. For roller, our U2 will be 0. So we have to give this at the smooth. Continue. 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. Amplitude. Done. So we have applied the roller support here. We can look. This is roller support. Okay. Now we have to apply load. So look into the figure. This is concentrated load at here. So 50 kN. So concentrated load. Rated load. Continue. Select this point. Turn. And it is in direction of Y. Downward direction. And its magnitude is 50 kN. Means 50000 in Newton. Amplitude. Okay. Now we have to go for one more loading. and that will be line load. Line load is our UDL of 10 kN per meter. Select line load, then name it as a UDL. Continue. Select this beam, turn. Magnitude is here minus 10,000. Amplitude 10 kN per meter. Okay. So loading is done. Now we have to go for meshing. We'll be selecting all. So we'll seed it. I am keeping it by size as 0.5. Okay. Now we have to mesh part instances. Yes, meshing is done. Now we should go for step and we will select those nodes where we are interested. For wire element, we don't need to create set. We can directly get result from that visualization. So we're going for job. We'll create a job. Create. We can write continuous beam. Continuous beam. Continue. We cannot give spaces here. Before running this, I have to give orientation. I forgot to give. In the property section, I will go for assign beam orientation. I have to select this beam. Done. Enter. Okay. Beam orientation is done. Now we can go for job and we can run that job. Submit. We can monitor it. We have to wait till it will be completed. Completed. Dismiss. We can check results. So U. So U 2. So we can get rotations at roller analytically. So U 3. So at this, we can go for this. Your information and at probe value we can check UR3 values. So this is our node 2. At we can select probe as a node gain level. We know that our roller node is node number 2 right now and we'll enter it. It's coming 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 and our analytical value is 3.584 to 10 to the power minus 4. So it's almost similar. So we have to go for convergence study. I have done it. So I have done it till this 0.025 meshing and I'm getting rotation at mid support as this. And these are the values of convergence. And we can check right support rotation also by my right support. Number is node 4, so I'll be writing node 4 here. It's coming 10.17 10 to the power minus 4 and our analytical value is 10.125. we can go for convergence. It's converging here only 10.16. we can check reactions. So for reactions I have to select here RF. So our reaction will be at this support and this support. So firstly I will look for left support. It's 1. So it's coming 22395.6 and analytical value is 22420. So it's almost similar. Convergence will give the accurate results. Now we can check right support. Right support is 4. 17672.1 and analytical is 17640. Now we can check the mid. It's 2. No number is 2. It's coming 599321 and analytical is 59940. It's coming. We have to check moment at the left support. So So for moment, we can go for RM3. Moment will be at 1. Rest support will be 0. At rest support will be 0. Moment is coming 16289.8. Analytically is 165322. So it's matching. We can look in the figure with the symbolic way also. It's deflecting like this. And we have to go for due to. It's deflecting like this U2. And reactions also we can see these other reactions. So thank you.